Hi, welcome to Megish Biology online classes. Those who have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe to get the newly uploading videos. Let's discuss about a new topic that is cell cycle and cell division. Multicellular organisms, their life cycle begins from single cell, that is zygote. That zygote, it undergoes repeated mitotic divisions that helps to formation of one new individual organism. During cell division, the cell cycle play very important role. So during cell cycle, some major events occurs. The cyclic events, whatever occurs during cell division, all those events together call cell cycle. So first event, that is duplication of genome. Genome, total complete genetic material of the cell, the total duplicates, that is the major important event that occurs during cell division. So synthesis of other constituents, during cell division various components, various cell organelles, proteins, RNA molecules, different types of components are synthesized which are necessary for cell division. That is the second major event that occurs during cell cycle. Next, so division of cell, that is the final major event that occurs during cell cycle. But all these cyclic events, that duplication of genome, synthesis of new components, and the final cell divides into two daughter cells, all these cyclic events together called cell cycle. Phases of cell cycle. Human body cell, it takes around 24 hours time for one complete division. Human body cell takes around 1 day or 24 hours time for one complete cell division. The 24 hours, we can say that is 1 day. That is approximate time required for one complete cell division. But whereas yeast is best example for unicellular fungus, that takes only 90 minutes for one complete division. 90 minutes, we can say that is 1.5 hour time. So based on these two statements, our human body cells takes 24 hours or 1 day, whereas yeast cell takes 90 minutes duration of the time for one complete cell division. Based on this, what we can understand, different cells, they takes a different time for one complete cell division. There are mainly two phases are there in the cell cycle. First phase, that is interphase. Second phase, young phase. Cell cycle, two phases, interphase and young phase. Interphase again divided into three subphases, that is G1, S phase, G2. These are three major subphases of interphase. But here, M phase again it is divided into two subphases. So here that is karyokinesis, cytokinesis. Karyokinesis, that is a division of nucleus. Cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. But during karyokinesis, again there are four subphases are there. So that is a first prophase, second subphase metaphase, third anaphase, last telophase. These are the four subphases that is included in karyokinesis. At the end of the cytokinesis, two cells will form. But here, cell cycle includes these two phases. One single cell, if it enters into the interphase and the M phase, that is including karyokinesis, cytokinesis. So two daughter cells will form at the end of the M phase. Diagrammatic view of total entire cell cycle. This is G1, that is interphase, first subphase, S phase, G2 phase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, cytokinesis. But all these total two major phases, that is interphase and M phase, that is diagrammatic view. Once we'll see what happens during cell cycle. So once one single cell that enters into the G1 phase, one single cell it entered into the G1 phase. So from G1 phase to cell enters into the S phase, S phase to G2 phase. After G2 phase, that cell enters into the prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, cytokinesis. At the end of the cytokinesis, two daughter cells will form. So here every cell during cell division, that is mitosis, so compulsory that cell it should process like this in all these subphases. Initially cell enters into the G1, then from G1 to cell enters into the S phase, from S phase to cell enters into the G2 phase, so from G2 phase to M phase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, cytokinesis, that is karyokinesis, cytokinesis, together called M phase. So at the end of the cytokinesis, two cells are formed. Again these two cells enter into the cell cycle, four cells will form. But here major three subphases of interphase, that is G1, S, G2. From here to here, that is from G1 to G2, G1, S, G2 together called interphase. Interphase, it takes more than 95% of the time. That is a very important phase. It takes more than 95% of time. Imagine. So here the it takes more time for one complete. Next, cell after interphase that enters into the M phase. So M phase duration of the time that is very less because it is divisional phase. It may has prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, cytokinesis, like this various suffrages may be there, but it takes only 5% of time for total entire cell cycle. In exam, what they will give, arrange the following subphases of interphase sequential order. So interphase subphases, the sequences, what we can say, G1, S, G2. Next, in M phase, arrange the following subphases of M phase sequential order. That is, karyokinesis, it has 4 subphases. Cytokinesis, at the end of the cytokinesis only 2 cells will form. At the end of the telophase, 2 nuclei will form within cell, but after cytokinesis finally 2 daughter cells will form. So now we'll discuss what are the major events occurs in G1 phase. Before going to learn, we'll study about one more phase, that is G0 phase. G0, that is also called quiescent phase. So here some cells like heart cells and neurons, they exit from G1 to enter into the G0 phase. That is inactive phase, that is called G0 phase. Actually, cells after G1, cells should enter into the S phase. But whereas our heart cells, neurons, that is matured heart cells, matured neurons, cells, instead of entering into the S phase, G1 cells enters into the inactive phase, that is called quiescent phase or stage, that is inactive stage. Cells in this stage, they will not divide, so permanently they remains in quiescent stage or inactive stage, our heart cells and as well as neurons. But here these are completely muscle cells and as well as neurons, they are completely differentiated.